Our All-Metro offense is led by mammoth tackle Chantrell Henderson of Creighton-Durham Hall. The senior is 6'8", 320 pounds. Watch Henderson block on this play. He is regarded as the nation's number one college recruit, a five-star player, and a can't-miss college star. He's being recruited by USC, Florida, Notre Dame, Ohio State, and others. Chantrell is so strong, quick, and technically sound, just a tremendous blocker with a great sense of balance, which makes him the best in the country. Henderson is a three-year starter and a repeat All-Metro performer. Irondale's Jimmy Jerry is also a big man at 6'8", 300 pounds. Jerry is a repeat All-Metro player. Watch Jerry, number 76, with this block. He was a dominant lineman for 2 years. He's strong with good feet and great awareness. Watch Jimmy block on this play. His coach says Jerry is the real deal, a devastating blocker who works hard and has a great future. Jimmy is verbally committed to the Gophers. Eden Prairie guard Nick Harris is big and strong at 6'6", 285. Watch number 79 block on this play. Head coach Mike Grant says Harris moved from tackle to guard and has dominated opponents. He hasn't given up a sack all season. Harris is so athletic, which makes him a devastating pull and trap blocker, the next in a long line of great ones at Eden Prairie. The Eagles have 2,792 yards rushing this fall, a lot of those behind Harris. Matamidi junior tackle Tom Olson is a big man at 6'4", 285. Watch Olson, number 58, with his pancake block. The Zephyrs rushed for 2,427 yards, a lot of those behind Olson. He's extremely physical, very strong, with excellent technique and room to grow. Olson is already verbally committed to the Gophers, and you can see why. He's a good one. Matamidi finished 10-2 on the season. Blaine center Max Chapman was voted the Northwest Suburban Conference Offensive Lineman of the Year. Watch Chapman, number 55. He's 6'1", 295. Head coach Shannon Garrity says Chapman is a very tough, determined competitor. Blaine's offense averaged 378 yards per game, and when they needed the tough yard, they ran behind Chapman. He was a three-year starter at Blaine, which says a lot. Buffalo lineman Ben Henson was named the Mississippi 8 Conference MVP. Watch Henson, number 76, with his block. He's 6'3", 305, and a powerful two-way player for the Bison. He was a three-year starter and never missed a play in that time. His coach says he's extremely strong with quick feet for a big guy. He's a Division I college recruit. At times, Shea Walker played in the shadow of Chantrell Henderson at Creighton-Durham Hall, but he's a star in his own right. Watch Walker, number 74, block on this play. He's 6'2", 292, and some consider him a nastier blocker than Henderson. The Raiders have amassed over 4,000 yards of offense, most of it coming behind Walker and Henderson. Creighton coach Mike Scanlon says Walker is an outstanding drive blocker and one reason the Raiders are in the state 5A semifinals. Our All-Metro running backs are led by De La Salle's Evan Williams. Watch Williams, number 28, take off on this long touchdown run. He played quarterback for the Islanders, but was more of a threat to run the football. He finished the season with 2,200 yards on 183 carries and 31 touchdowns. He also threw for over 1,200 yards and 10 other scores, all of that despite missing 2 games with injuries. In 2 years, the senior amassed 4,346 yards on the ground and 63 touchdowns. He's a Gopher recruit. Champlain Park's Brandon Marquardt was named the Northwest Suburban Conference Offensive MVP. Watch Marquardt, number 22, take off on this great touchdown run. The 5'10", 195-pounder finished with 1,513 yards on 240 carries and 21 touchdowns. He also caught 22 passes for over 400 yards and 6 touchdowns. He was a threat to score every time he touched the football. Watch Marquardt on this run. He was a three-year starter and finished his career with 2,851 yards and 55 touchdowns, most in Champlain Park school history. Totino Grace senior John Crockett was tough to tackle and hard to catch. Watch Crockett, number 23, on this touchdown run. He was the best offensive player in the North Suburban Conference. He dekes out the defense with a spin move, Crockett at 6'1", 180, is a tough runner with exceptional speed. He has 1,494 yards on 149 carries this fall. Watch Crockett on this play. He's so explosive off the line of scrimmage and almost impossible to run down. John has 28 rushing touchdowns and over 2,100 all-purpose yards. Minneapolis Washburn Jr. Montrell Wade was dynamite in a small package. Watch Wade, number two, on this long touchdown run. He ripped off scoring runs of 95 and 89 yards this fall on his way to a total of 2,122 yards on 211 carries. That's a 10-yard per carry average. Wade is just 5'11", 185, but he's strong and very fast. He scored 19 touchdowns for the Millers, who won the Minneapolis City Conference and finished 8-3. Our All-Metro quarterback is Andover junior Tyler Finnis, who had a breakout season. Finnis is a big quarterback at 6'4", 180, and he throws a great football. He completed 65% of his passes, connecting on 201 of 307 this season for 2,326 yards and 25 touchdowns. The junior has a strong arm, and he made the most of it. He also was a threat to run the football, gaining 622 yards on 128 carries and 10 touchdowns. He led Andover to a 7-3 record. Our All-Metro receivers are led by Finnis' favorite target at Andover, Jason Schneider. He's 6'5", 210. Watch Schneider, number 9, make the great catch. The senior finished with 73 receptions for 904 yards and 13 touchdowns. He made the tough play look easy. Watch Schneider on this catch. His coach says the 6'5 wideout is the best his program has ever had, and you can see why. Rosemont senior Zach Braw is a repeat All-Metro performer and a candidate for Minnesota's Mr. Football. Watch Braw, number 82, make this great catch. He averaged 20 yards per reception, which led the Metro. He's a big target at 6'3", 200 pounds. His numbers were down from a year ago, but not his impact. Braw was a threat to score every time he touched the ball. Zach finished with 39 catches for 783 yards, but he scored 12 touchdowns. Rosemont finished 7-4. Osseo junior receiver Jameer Jackson led the Metro in receptions with 86 for 1,139 yards. Watch Jackson, number 15, make this great touchdown catch. The 6'3", 210-pounder finished with 15 touchdown receptions. His coach says Jackson has great size and strength, and he uses his body well. Jameer set a state record for receptions in a game with 19 versus Andover in September. He was a threat to score each time he touched the ball. Osseo finished 4-6. Our All-Metro tight end is Eden Prairie senior Taylor Grant. He's 6'5", 230. Watch Grant make the touchdown catch. He has 14 receptions for 225 yards and 4 touchdowns. He's averaging 16 yards per catch. He's also a very good blocker. Grant is a multi-talented player and has seen time at quarterback and on defense. He's being recruited Division I. Eden Prairie is 11-0 and in the state 5A semifinals. Our All-Metro kicker is Northfield senior Wes Kramer, who's a big guy at 6'4", 270. Watch Kramer, number 62, make this long field goal. He made 5 of 6 field goal attempts, his longest from 44 yards. Kramer made 14 field goals in his high school career. Wes also put half of his kickoffs into the end zone. He was also a standout lineman and one big reason Northfield made the state 4A quarterfinals, finishing 8-3. And our choice for Coach of the Year is Centennial's Mike Watson. This is Mike's 32nd year at Centennial, and this year, his team won a share of the Northwest Suburban Conference title. He beat Blaine twice, and the Cougars made the state football playoffs for the third time in their history. Centennial finished this season 10-2. Last year, they were 2-7, the greatest turnaround in school history. Congratulations to Mike Watson of Centennial High School.